lot, which is essentially our basketball court and our kitchen. And then we volunteered fire station for 60 years. And when we were county, the Orange County Fire Authority essentially disbanded the volunteer program, in which this was, if you will, excess property. And we had an opportunity to purchase it. Our community had an opportunity to purchase it. And we were offered it at a very good price, only $200,000. So that sounds great. Except we had a 3-month time limit, and we had zero money. I mean, zero money. So we had a just an incredible fundraising effort. And the people whose names are up on that donor board donated here so we could purchase it. We were able to accomplish it and purchase this building in the 3-month time frame. Now, that's part of the story. The other part of the story is this was in such terrible shape, it actually cost us $250,000 to get it to the shape that you see it right now, which meant another fundraising, more fundraising. So it's been a labor of love, but we're so proud to have this, our volunteer fire station, be part of our community center and to have our meetings here. This is a special one with our candidates forum. We kind of fell into it somewhat. 5 years ago, we were annexed, and about a year into it was a city council race. And so we thought, well, we still don't know Huntington Beach very well, and let's face it, Huntington Beach didn't know anything about us but the craziness that they read in the newspapers. So we thought it was going to be a real nice, be a nice time to get to know each other. And it was a warm evening. We had it outside in the lot, and it was well turned out, and it turned out to be really a fun evening. So we did it again two years ago, and once again I thought it was a good exchange, and it was a nice time. So it's always the first Thursday of September, which just turns out to be essentially the first time that the candidates get together to talk. So kind of like New Hampshire, first day. So that's what we're doing today. So and to see such a great turnout is a testimonial to your interest and to the pride we have here at Sunset Beach in supporting the community. So we're gonna go down and basically some introductions, some treasurer's report, public comments, and then we're gonna have our speakers forum, a little bit of business, and then we're gonna be mainly talking to the candidates afterwards. So without further ado, we'd like to start with the flag salute. Rob, would you go out and
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Candidate for tonight, but number one in the ballot. I'm also candidate number two on the ballot.
I'm Kathleen Nutting, Huntington Beach.
Ashford and Brandon, Huntington Beach, candidates one.
Phil Nutting, Huntington.
Stacy Massey, Huntington Beach.
Michael Grant, Huntington Beach.
Julie Grant, Huntington Beach.
Alan Traversky, Huntington Beach.
Lorraine Crawford, Huntington Beach.
Julie Larissa, Sunset Beach, South Huntington Beach.
Sue Porter, Fourth Street, Sunset Beach.
Kathy Hammond, Huntington Beach.
Alicia Langley, Fourth Street.
Julie Bixby, Huntington Beach.
Mark Bixby, Huntington Beach.
Ed Pinchin, Huntington Beach, City Council candidate.
Patrick Prentice, Huntington Beach, City Council candidate.
Bob Russell, Huntington Beach.
Teresa Fourteenth Street.
Kathy Brandon, Huntington Beach.
Jean Driscoll, South Pacific Beach.
Sharif Coates, Fourteenth Street.
Dennis McKeel, Fifth Street.
Mark Brown, Sunset Beach, Sixth Street.
Register.
Go ahead.
Have him register, Greg Allen.
All right.
My turn. My name is Amory Manson, I'm a candidate for Huntington Beach City Council, I live in Huntington Beach, and I'm number six here and number five on the ballot.
Denise Van Boris, Sunset Beach, Park Avenue.
Brett Van Boris, Sill Beach.
Carrie Sloan, Huntington Beach.
Kelly Sullivan, Sunset Beach.
Marianne Etzor, Huntington Beach, and I'm a candidate for City Council.
Denise Wilson, Sunset Street.
Denise Wilson, Sunset Street.
Linda White Sullivan, Huntington Beach.
Carol Woodworth, Huntington Beach.
Brandy Walde, Huntington Beach, and the Senate.
Greg Griffin, 23rd Street.
Margaret Douglas, City Council member, Huntington Beach.
Lisa Johnson, Huntington Beach.
Ben Johnson, Huntington Beach. Courtney Gilbass, Huntington Beach. Sorry, what am I saying? You put me off. I'm in Sunset Beach, the Broadway. Okay, sorry.
Troy Valenzuela, the pair of Sunset Beach on South Pacific.
Vicky Valenzuela, Sunset Beach.
Tony Sella, Huntington Beach.
Robert Gray Height, Huntington Beach. Roy Lawson, Huntington Beach.
Norm Lawson, Huntington Beach.
Al Star, 14th Street. Maybe we should make me a write-in. Take a look.
Rob Driscoll, South Pacific. Kevin Walson, 7th Street.
Carol Castle, Bayview.
Tony Hill, South Pacific.
Mike Van Boris, Park Avenue.
Jim McCormick, 27th Street.
Harry Ward, 17th Street. And the two strikers?
Two strikers. Graham Oak, Rose, and
sorry, so that's good.
Three strikers. Welcome.
Yeah, there's two strikers there.
Great. Let's see. We have taken the summer off, so we haven't had any meetings in July or August. But so our last meeting was June. We did distribute the June minutes. We posted the June minutes at the bulletin board of the post office. Does anyone have any corrections to our June minutes? If not, we'll accept the minutes as posted. Carolyn, do you have a treasurer's report?
I do. Our general balance today is $13,879.90. Our account to spend is $8,788.90, and our leaving savings is $5,091.
We have no correspondence. So now we're going to move into our public comments. Public comments is if anyone would like to say anything about anything that's not on the agenda. And tonight, with this being such a special evening, if there's anything that you want to get off your chest, this is a good night to do it because we have, there's two city council candidates that are not here tonight. But call me Nostradamus. Chances are that the three candidates who are ultimately going to win the election are in this room tonight. We have Barbara Del Blaze, who is almost certainly going to be our mayor this coming year. So basically what we have is the majority of the city council for next year is sitting in this room. So folks, if there's anything that you would like to say, this is a great night to do it. Although I am going to start off with Kathy Hammond, the president of the Women's Club, who wants to talk about the Chili Dog Pot.
Well, this will be our 19th year. It's going to be right here in the community. And what we do with the Women's Club, we give the proceeds to scholarships for our future kids and also adults that want to continue for their education. So what we're doing is we're going to have beer and wine. We're going to have raffle prizes. We're going to have a live auction. We're going to have a great custom-made bike. That's awesome. And so I've been hitting the streets and getting some great gift certificates, but we also need support with our expenses because the more money that we get, the more we can give to our community center here for the best week here, also for our Women's Club. So I'm going to just leave a few right here on the table so if any can help out. I've already got Robin to help out with the ABC permit because we're going to have beer and wine here for the permit. And that's fun. And also we're going to have root beer for the kids. So it's fun for everyone. You can bring your little dogs. So Holly, have I forgotten anything else?
The band.
Kent Reed is amazing. And he's offered to play the other costumes. So we just want y'all to come, taste the chili, judge because we have people's choice with what you pick for the chili. And I think that's about it. So I know that we can use it. Thank you.
We're very proud. We have a Sunset Beach walking tour map. It was actually put on in conjunction with some folks here at Sunset Beach and also with Visit Huntington Beach. They thought it was a good idea to preserve our history and that visitors would also like to take a stroll through town and see some of our interesting points of interest and a little bit of our history. So. Before you go tonight, for anyone who does not have a walking tour map, you would be happy to make one and come back and explore our town. Okay, public comments. Oh, Tony, you're the most passionate man I know. Go ahead.
My name is Tony Salas. I'm the guy that been studying the Sunset Beach specific plan. When Peter's Island was going to get rezoned, I started. And they turned it down. I started looking at the Sunset Beach specific plan. Then a mixed use project just got voted on and approved over here on August 9th. And I actually went in there and started taking a look at the plans and compared it to what's in the Sunset Beach specific plan. And there was actually five major violations that violate the Sunset Beach specific plan. Robin right here has a big, huge email list. And I put this giant report together, and if you want to get in contact with her and see what the report is. But this is a great opportunity for us residents or of this area to actually take a look at the Sunset Beach specific plan, see what the interpretation of the Huntington Beach Planning Community Arts Department is. And what we need to do is actually get together and get our definitions correct, because I'm looking at this in Sunset Beach, the Planning Department and Huntington Beach is saying something different. We need to get on the same page, get the same terminology. That way our LCP can evaluate a property over here in the commercial district and know what the zoning people on Huntington Beach are saying, but it's completely different right now. So I ask you to please get in contact with the LCP board. I'm gonna get in contact. We've gotta start having meetings and we've gotta evaluate what's going on here.
Thanks, Tony. I know Cookie wants to speak. And the reason I say this, I ran into Jake Feinberg at the post office today. Him and his wife don't come to these meetings all that often. He says, she wants to come and she has some things to say, so.
So we set me up.
So we did, so go for it.
When we're here, we like to come to meetings.
Oh, absolutely. And we do, and I should also mention, we try to keep this to 3 minutes. We're not real strict, but try to.
Well, I have a request and then I have an appeal. And my request is from 19th Street, I walk every day, my dog up and down. I
They were long walks, short walks, from Anderson all the way down. And from 19th Street to Anderson, the green space is not a green space anymore. It is dirt, it is sand, and it is being washed out. So it's not just not attractive, it's being decimated by any amount of water that comes in, whether it's rain or whatever, and it's washing down and out into the street. The sprinklers, I don't think, work at all. I saw somebody out there doing some work with the sprinklers, and I'm like, what are you doing? There's no grass. Oh, the sprinklers will bring back the grass. I'm like, I don't think so. The sprinklers still don't work. And then on 17th Street, there's a dead tree that I noticed today. And there's other areas down below 19th Street. It really needs to be addressed because it's not the way it was when we were Sunset Beach. It's not the way it should be. I won't even go into the trash. I'm the only one who can't trash them down. And I really think that we need to address Huntington Beach, that they need to do something with our green space. That's number one. Number two is, I would appreciate in the minutes that go out an appeal to everybody that lives up and down North and South Pacific, and heck, anywhere else, because we get people from all over. I mean, I'm meeting dogs from Torrance. I mean, we have people from all over who walk up and down because we're the only green space in a long distance. But I'd like to issue an appeal that when people bring their trash cans out, just within 10 steps, go and pick up the trash and put them in your trash bag. It'll make a good contribution to what is just, we're becoming a third world area here. Between the dead grass, the dead trees, and the trash, it's just, it's wrong. So maybe an appeal in the paper to just observe, pick up these trash. Buy the nickel for every bottle cap I picked up and every cigarette butt I picked up. I could buy that overpriced caps, you know. Whatever street that is.
I have reason to believe that's going to be a note in our minutes right now. So, thanks.
Something along that lines on 14th Street, and I know there's a couple other places, they put in the big power boxes.
Yeah.
And similar to what you're talking about, when they got done, they covered it with a nice colored sod. They put
grass. We just get sod up here.
They put, no, the dirt. Nice colored looking like sod. Then they put seeds on it. And sure enough, the first time the sprinklers came on, all that stuff washed down into the 14th Street ravine. And just as a side note, when I shoveled it all up and I took it down to another spot where there was no grass, if you go up there now, you'll find a whole bunch of green, tall blades of grass from all the seeds that I shoveled up and threw back into the middle of the green. So the other thing is that whenever we have people come in and supposedly do upgrades to our community as far as power, lines underground, those kinds of things, further note needs to be put into the plans as to what it does to the green belt, because now at the end of 14th Street we have a sand dune, and every other day when the sprinklers do come on, they basically wash what's there left down into the sidewalk area and then on into the gutter. So that's just an additional comment left to go along with the green belt. So I know ours isn't the only one. I'm sure there are other stories, but
I think if you drive from one end of town to the other, it's pretty consistent. There was another, you already had it. There was another hand over here, actually.
Yeah. Couple things. One is I couldn't kind of throw my thunder on the green belt issue, but I appreciate that. She said a lot more eloquently than I did. Green belt's turning. I don't mind the brown belt because due to the drought, but the sand belt is becoming a little bit excessive. So I don't know how much it's going to cost to actually resod that, but I think we're kind of throwing the baby out with the bathwater as far as how much it's actually going to cost to maintain that. If we have to bring it back from when it completely turns to sand, I think it's going to be a problem. The other thing is I serve on the sanitary district, which is we're the district that takes care of when you flush the toilets and it goes somewhere, that's what we do. And then we take out the trash too. One thing that's come up at our meetings, kind of time and time again over the last several months, has to do with flushing those wipes that use the Clorox wipes and things that you guys use. And I know that Jim, our superintendent, has just been crazy maniacal about this, but I figured this is as good of time as any. If you put it in the notes, please, people, don't flush those Clorox wipes down the toilet. They plug up our sewer system down here, and it's been a problem. We're tired of discussing that. But anyway, I'll just leave that out there. But I wanted to reiterate what could be said about this.
Kathy, if I told you, I had no idea what was going to come out of your mouth.
Yeah, you never know, but I appreciate that.
Yes, I would like to discuss a couple items with the board, two of which I brought you petitions to. The first one was about the signings to put Sunset Beach up on our community building. I presented that to you in 2013 with no answer to date. And when I asked about my petition, where it is, there's no board member that could present it, so it's magically disappeared. What I'd like to do for the record is reinstate that petition. I'd like to have Sunset Beach put up on our building. I don't think there's any board member up here that could justify why we can't do that. I'd like to have it in red letters to represent the fire station and the men and women that worked here before. If you have to take up a collection, I'm willing to do that. Second thing is another petition which involved this Halloween extravaganza that's just not conducive to using our community center. We've tried it for 4 years. On an average, it's taken over 60 days of the community center. Last year, it was 83 days that nobody got to come in here and do that. Las Thomas has done a great job for over 50 years for the children. It's not for teenagers or adults. We're mainly concerned about the kids. And it's one day up, one day down. Like, I think if we can't maintain that, I think it should not be in this venue. It should be somewhere else. Or hold it in here. We can do this for 8 months, but not our community center. That's for any person that wants to come in here, kick a ball, or whatever they want to do. They should not be denied access to our community center. So I want that to be reinstated also. And I'd like an answer from the board eventually. Instead of letting 3 years go by to put something as simple as Sunset Beach on, there's a lot of community pride that we have here, and I think there's a ton of people that talk to you that want that. I spent hours, and I got 170 names to do that. We, as far as I understand, the board is just a representative. When we bring something to people that's, you know, logical, I think that's a logical situation. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, Tony, you're out too.
I don't know if you guys noticed the construction under the water tower. It sold that for $1.5 million, so I missed out.
Yeah.
So maybe people will be living there. I don't know.
Well, you guys went easy on us tonight on the public comments.
Thank you.
If there are no more, we're going to now go on to our new business, which is our main topic tonight, and that is to hear our city council candidates. Tonight, right before we started, we had everyone's name on the back of a business card, and we drew it, and this is the order in which we have our speakers. And speakers, we would like you to not go over 5 minutes. I'm going to time you at 4 minutes. I'll give you a one finger. We've got a few voters in here. We could have bought an air hog. And then the other thing, I've never known a city council candidate to be bashful. That being said, we don't have a microphone. We have a little bit of the traffic noise, so make sure that you speak loud. And Joe Hardy, you're
Well, I think I'll use my teacher voice. School started yesterday for my students, and my fifth period had 57 students enrolled in it when we started. We're down to 47. It'll get down to 37 by next week. But I have to speak loudly to a large group of room and a large group of kids in the room. There we go. Okay, got my first nervous thing then. And they're freshmen, and so they talk a lot more than you do. So thank you already for being a wonderful group. And you smell better too. I do want to say thank you for having all of us candidates tonight. It's always a pleasure to visit Sunset Beach and come to this meeting and be a part of this, especially tonight. So thank you for being here. I am Jill Hardy. I am part of a five-generation Huntington Beach family. My family moved here in 1926, and my children are the fifth generation. I went to Assn High School. I taught at Huntington Beach High School for several years. In fact, one of my students is in this room, and several of the parents of my students are in this room. I now teach at Marina High School, and this week I started my 23rd year of teaching.
Well, thank you.
I have a bachelor's degree in economics mathematics and a master's degree in economics, and I've been a council member for three terms now. I first was elected in 2002, and I served as mayor in 2005 and 2015. As a council member, one of the things I've done is serve on the Sunset Beach Council Subcommittee since its inception, except for the 2 years that I was not on City Council. I asked to be on that committee, and I continue to ask to be on it, and hopefully next year's mayor will allow me to. And part of the reason is because I was there when the annexation process for Sunset Beach got started, and I was very concerned about making sure that Sunset Beach felt welcome and heard. And, you know, so I remember the 14 points, and I remember the promise to honor what the county was doing. Now, somewhere in between there, sometimes the county undid what they had been doing, so sometimes there's confusion. But I'm glad and proud to have served on that committee. Part of the reason I pushed for this committee to be part of the annexation process was because I've also served on the Southeast Huntington Beach Committee since its inception, except for 2 years I wasn't on City Council. And I found that regular meetings with a group of residents really helped to get some issues out that the city just wasn't aware of, and also kind of kept a fire lit under some of our staff members. So one of the things I'd like to see in the Sunset Beach Committee is more regular meetings. It doesn't meet very often because it's kind of as needed, and in my opinion, as needed is at least twice a year, preferably quarterly, and maybe even every other month. So I'd like to see more regular meetings, not because there's necessarily a specific issue, but because getting together with city staff and talking with them is super important. I didn't hear any public comments that I wasn't already aware of. I've heard about the green space in the center and the concern about the grass, but it feels like nothing's getting done. I feel like we had regular Sunset Beach committee meetings that our public works staff would hear more and feel the urgency in addressing this sooner rather than later. This didn't come up tonight, but in the roundabout at over by Wilson Chica State Beach, there's been a request, hey, can we landscape that? Well, that requires some cooperation with the state. We were going to have a regular meeting, and staff knew what was going to come up at that meeting, which is going to be the roundabout once again. Then somebody would say, hey, you know what? I've got to make that call to the state again and push it. But they're not making that call regularly because we're not reminding them. So I'm hoping that this board will work with the city to have more regular Sunset Beach subcommittee, and that you all come and participate and listen, make sure that the issues are heard and heard regularly, because that really helps a lot. The two things that I'm really making sure everybody knows that I'm about, opposing high density housing. I voted against the zoning change in Peter's Landing, preserving open space. And overall, the theme is preserving the character and culture of the community we chose to live in, which I know was the number one issue when Sunset Beach got annexed, preserving the character and culture of Sunset Beach. We feel the same way throughout Huntington Beach. And if you haven't picked this up, it's a great read whether you walk around or not, but it comes with exercise if you do. Thank you.
Warm
minutes and 49 seconds. Good job. Mark Ross.
Good evening, everybody. I'm the new guy. First thing we're going to do, if I do get elected, is I'm going to put a movement afoot that we move this meeting outside. again, I'm new to this, and I will tell you this. I'm a very, very hard worker. I'm honest as the day is long, and I will fight for everything that you're looking for. I've been doing my research extensively on all the issues that plague or that bother everyone from Huntington Beach or from Sunset Beach. As I see it, if I live in Sunset Beach, we now have the benefit of the Huntington Beach Fire and Police Department. Other than that, like, leave us alone. I'm from the East Coast originally. This Sunset Beach reminds me of Avalon or Ocean City and the Jersey Shore. These are the kind of communities that are fast disappearing in the United States, and you want to preserve this. This is what makes this country so great. There are nagging issues, though, that Jill mentioned that just don't get addressed. The green belt. It's not a green belt, it's a tan belt. But it looked better right now as a railroad track than it does how it looks now. So you can't just sod it because it's going to die. So you need to come up with a plan that is functional with a designer or a landscaper to come up with a functional design that can handle a lot of traffic, foot traffic, as well as bikes and the community and everything else, and still stay green and look as it should or proper. The turnaround, I call it the two lots down here at the end of Pacific Highway, Joe mentioned also. To me, that's an Eagle Scout project. Right? That is really simple. I heard about this the other day when I was talking with Mike. I was like, you're kidding me. This is so simple. But you get people involved who tend to want to argue about these things instead of fixing them. That's a simple fix. It should have been done a long time ago. And it looks terrible for the community. The other is that I noticed was the median going the length of Sunset Beach from one end to the other in the street. There's a partial, but I've heard you all want a full median strip up there. I'm all for that. It would help make the street of Pacific Coast Highway look a lot better, and it can be done. And then you sit there and say, how are we going to fund something? Well, if you decide that you're going to approve that there's a small boutique hotel goes in where the car wash used to be, then work with them to make them pay for the median strip as part of their entry fee into the city. There's a lot of things that can be done if you partner with the right people. The other was, and I know these are small, minor things, but for the kayak renters out here, just three of them in the Sunset Beach community, they've all agreed that they would put decals on the boats to say right away the three basic steps of, safe boating. It's not been done yet. And it's not a matter of having to do a study, or it's not a matter of, like, well, what's going to cost us or anything else. I've known plenty of people that would find this, even myself, buy the decals and put on there, and it's a simple fix. But we still talk about it. It hasn't been done. It should be done. These are simple, simple things. What else do I have here? The short-term rentals in Sunset Beach. So I don't know if anybody here rents short-term rentals, but that it's an issue. And I'm not going to avoid them. But if you're going to have short-term rentals, then there should be some rules in place. This is standard operating procedure in other parts of the country. Have a three-day rental minimum, and if you are a three-strike store, if you don't have it, if you break the rules in three times, then you can't rent them. So these are things, they're just rules that need to be enforced. And it's not overbearing rules, they're just things that need to be enforced to make your community better. Getting outside the Sunset Beach area, or let's say the high-density development was, I'm against high-density development. I know we do need housing, but the way it's being done right now is a mess, I think. If you go down to Beach and Ellis, you look at that, if that's what the setback is, I'm shocked. That building looks like it goes up and out as it goes up. And it's awfully close to the street. If I'm a pedestrian walking up that off Beach Boulevard, I'm nervous that I'm going to get a car hit there. So these basic things need to be addressed. You can design buildings to suit or to fit into a neighborhood. I'm not saying I'm anti-building, but if you're going to build, do it right and do it with everybody else's consensus. All right? This is a close-knit community. We should listen to the people here. So that's me in a nutshell. I'll be around if you need to say anything to me directly or whatever. I'm available, I'm approachable. Talk to me, I'd love to talk to you. So, and hear everything you have to say. Right? Okay, thank you.
I agree. There's a lot of people standing by the door back there, so I don't mind. I'll take off my jacket.
We forgot. We usually wear Hawaiian shirts here.
Anyway, thank you all for being here this evening and for this opportunity to address you. My wife here, Antoinette, who you probably heard when she introduced herself, she and I came to Huntington Beach 22 years ago. And the reason we came to Huntington Beach is that we wanted to be by the ocean. We had both grown up near the ocean in LA County, but as you know, the cities up in LA County, like Manhattan Beach, Redondo Beach, are a little crowded, a little overcrowded. So when we found Huntington Beach, we decided this was the place we wanted to be and this is where we wanted to raise our family. And so we did. We came here 22 years ago. We have a 23-year-old son who just graduated from college. He just got his first full-time job, so I got a raise. Our daughter is 20 years old. She's going to be a junior this year. But first thing we did when we got to this community was we started volunteering. We were members of the St. Bonaventure Church, and in my only other attempt for elected office, I ran for parish council and was elected. I served on parish council there for 4 years. Kids got a little older, I started coaching hockey and got involved with Cub Scouts. And about 17 years later now, I have been involved with scouting ever since. Been Cub Master, Scout Master, been involved at the county level in a lot of different roles. But you know, that's how we got involved in the community and really got to know a lot of people. We also own a business, or did own a business. When we came here, it was called Home Run Media Group. We did printing, signs, and promotional products. And we employed as many as 30 people at one time. And we exited that business at the beginning of this year. And part of the reason for that, after 23 years of owning that business, I was ready for a new challenge. And over the past few years, I've gotten involved in the community and had the opportunity to become very active in the Chamber of Commerce, where I've served on the board for 8 years, most recently as chairman of the board. It became clear to me that there was a need for people to stand up and volunteer to be part of the public policy process. So I decided I wanted to run for city council a couple of years ago, but I decided not to do it until I could exit my business, because I believe this is really a job that requires an enormous amount of time and energy. And Barbara can certainly verify that. But I wanted to do the job the right way, so I waited until I could do it full time. And that's not a luxury that everyone has, but fortunately for me in my life, it is. As chairman of the board of the Chamber, there's a couple of things I'm very proud of. One is we started, under my leadership, we started a young entrepreneurs group. And that's getting off the ground now. And it was an attempt to bring some of our younger business owners and entrepreneurs into the business world and provide them some mentoring opportunities and bring some energy and small businesses to the Chamber. During my year as chairman, I participated in over 50 ribbon cuttings, and most of those ribbon cuttings were for small businesses in our community. And small businesses are part of the economic engine, a vital part of the economic engine, so I was very committed to that. Along the way, I had the opportunity to serve on several commissions, starting with the Charter Review Commission, and then on to the General Plan Advisory Committee, and then Public Works, and presently serving on the Planning Commission. That's been a great experience learning how the city operates, who's who in the city, and how to get things done. I've got a lot of endorsements, including Dana Rohrbacher, Travis Allen, Matt Harper, Michelle Steele, Jim Silva, and a lot of other elected officials around the county. I've also been endorsed by more than a dozen former Huntington Beach mayors, and those people come from every part of the political spectrum. And I point that out because I'm a person that's very much about collaboration. And you may have a different point of view than me, but what I want to do is sit down and discuss it with you. I want to get all the facts out on the table. I'm a facts-based guy, and so that's how I operate. We've got some big issues in this city, and I'm prepared to address those and deal with those
through that collaborative process, making sure that the public has a full participation in what we do. To wrap this up, I hope you agree that the experience and my involvement in the community has prepared me for this next step. Because I'm able to do this full time and making that commitment to you, that means I'm going to be there for you. When you call, when you text, when you email, whenever you have an issue, I will be available to you. I hope you'll be there for me on November 8th. I humbly ask for your vote. And my name is Patrick Brennan. I'm number 10 on the ballot. And maybe the last, but it's the best.
This opportunity. I especially love being in this room because I checked off one of my bucket list goals here very recently. At your Sunset Beach Art Festival, I sold my first piece of art. You do such a great job in this community of putting on these community events that make us all, you welcome all of us in the city. Love the Mother's Day. So, and I do want to commend Tony Sellis. I am Vice Chair of the Planning Commission right now. And you have been very diligent in understanding, you know, trying to understand what's going on with your plan. And it has been very interesting. We've had a few projects come through on the Planning Commission, kind of trying to go from what the county was doing to what our city is doing. There's been some confusion. So yes, we definitely need to, we are looking at amending some of the plan because of that. So thank you for your work. This, you know, my primary platform, honestly, is preserving this beach culture. You've heard it from a couple of us tonight. Because honestly, this little community here is kind of the model for that. It's just a microcosm of what makes a great community. And our whole city needs to be, we need to preserve that beach culture. So a little bit about myself. I grew up in Seal Beach, went to Huntington Beach High School. Can you hear me in the back, by the way? Went to Huntington Beach High School. So I could have learned so much more about the city at that time and what makes it special, and I've always appreciated that since. I'm somebody, I grew up in a fiscal conservative household, taught the value of community service, so I've always been involved in community service, and I went to UCLA for college and down to University of San Diego for law school, and became very involved in the community down there. I stayed and practiced law there for a little while before coming back. And I got involved with the homeless veterans, helping them with their legal problems. And through that, learned that women down there really, there were a lot of homeless women that were in hiding. So started an event for women's homeless women as well, kind of modeled after what the Vietnam vets were doing. And that's in its 26th year, and I'm proud of that history. I also was one of the initial volunteers at the restraining order clinic for battered women down there. But then my husband and I, we've been married 28 years, we had our two girls, and when they were very young, we decided we wanted to move back here. So we're 96, we wanted to raise our family here, we bought our home here in Huntington Beach. And I quickly became involved in this community because my daughter was diagnosed with autism. And because I was an attorney, I was approached by other parents and asked to sue the school districts on their behalf. But that's not really who I am. I'm someone that believes we work together to solve problems. So instead, I became co-chair of an organization, Women's Resource. I'm sorry, that was a different one. Orange County Autism Resource. And we worked really on channeling funds away from litigation into better services for the kids. So I'm proud of that as well. But you know, then it became clear that where my services were needed was in the city for us families to deal with. And so I was appointed first to the Investment Advisory Committee. And then to the Planning Commission, where, as I said, I served as Vice Chair. I really enjoyed that involvement. But serving on the Planning Commission, it became clear, and you all, I don't need to tell you this, we are building some massive apartment buildings on the beach of Ellis and down at Edgewater, and we're changing the character of the city. In what I think is a negative way, we are urbanizing the city, and that's not what we should be doing. We need to be more careful about how we're doing the government. And so that is my primary goal, is to work on that. Not bring those massive apartment buildings back. But you know what we need to do instead? Really is incentivize commercial growth better. Reasonable commercial growth, because that's what adds to our tax base and on an ongoing basis helps us meet our expenses. So I want to focus more on that. I also am very much wanting to increase transparency on Planning Commission. I've always welcomed that from everyone. And we'll continue to encourage expanding our ability to reach out and let you have your voice. Tonight, we heard from you in a small environment, but we want to hear from you up on City Council and Planning Commission as well. And some of you have been really good about coming down to Planning Commission and letting us know what's going on in your community. So those are some of the things I want to work on at City Council. I really hope that you vote. I appreciate, again, being here tonight. And thank you. Have a good time, babe.
Mayor. I'll take a yes.
It's hard.
That's very good. Hi, everybody. Thank you for coming. This is my first run at City Council, and I wanted to just give you a little bit of background. And I actually timed myself, so I'm 5 minutes and 2 seconds. by way of introduction, I'm a 26-year resident of Huntington Beach. I have served on the 4th of July board for a couple of years. I am a former board member and treasurer of MAD. I'm an 11-year board member, and I am also the secretary, and I sit on the finance committee of a 501c3. I am a CPA, and I have extensive experience in auditing and tax. I absolutely know how to read a financial statement, and I can detail a budget down to the minutia. I am also on the advisory panel of the AICPA Journal and the Tax Journal. I have a daughter who is a senior this year at Assn High School. She's a proud charter cheerleader. And after 10 years at Marina High School, our new cheer advisor came from Marina, and hopefully she's going to help us continue our winning tradition at Assn. So I think we are all here for the same reason. We want change, we want transparency, we want our voices heard, we want fiscal responsibility, we want a lot of things, we want safety. The voice of the community is not asking, it's begging to be heard. And City Council needs to listen to what the voice of the community is saying. How will I, as a City Council member, support the community and their needs and balance that with all the issues the city faces? We need to take a close look at where we're spending our money and where the money is being wasted. And yes, it's my money too, and I'm tired of it. We're not only spending too much money on projects, we're wasting money on projects that are irrelevant and offer little or no value whatsoever. We're not being smart about the money in many instances, and as a result, we end up diverting money that could be put towards the highest priority projects that will have the most immediate positive impact. I'm dissatisfied with what I believe is a non-supportive attitude of the residents' needs, and City Council members need to support the community and listen to the residents. There's a strong need to support and preserve the environment, the coast, and the open spaces of Huntington Beach. We need to come into compliance with the laws on low-income housing. We are leaving money on the table in state funding and possibly federal funding by our non-compliance. Further studies on traffic, low-income housing, effects on neighborhoods, and environmental impact need to be brought current, but we're hurting ourselves and limiting our ability to resolve other issues impacted by our lack of compliance. Safety is a high priority on my list, and I know it's an issue for many members of the community. We need to support the police and the fire personnel, and we need to work together towards our shared goals. I will be proactive in soliciting communication, keeping an open mind, open door policy. Build relationships and recognize that asking for help is a two-way street. And find a way to work together to start to make improvements in fixing these problems in the short term and the long term. There are building projects that are in the works. I have reviewed the pros and cons and read up extensively. I believe many of these have too great an impact on the environment, the surrounding neighborhoods. We don't know what the health risks are to our children, and the cost benefit is too high. We need to address unfunded liabilities and pension costs. If we don't address these issues now and find workable solutions, this will become a runaway train. Is this what we want to leave for our children? I don't believe it is. It's important to work with business leaders and identify opportunities for new business and create incentives to draw new business and new revenue to the city. We need to create incentives for the current businesses that are loyal to our community and for those we wish to attract. We We need to be evaluating traffic and the issues all the time and look at the impact of additional housing, businesses, and how we can better manage the flow. Okay. And whether the changes can be made to facilitate that. And we need to engage the local PD. Just briefly on the homeless and balancing the needs of the community, we need to take a role in working with other cities on available beds, research and financial assistance available, and this could be state and federal funding, low-income housing, soliciting help from local landlords, possible temporary housing. I mean, there's a whole lot that needs to be done here. But if we don't take steps to resolve these issues we face, because inaction is going to breed more and bigger problems at additional costs. So I will think independently and listen to the voice of the community. I come from a small town in Pennsylvania. It's full of charm and community, and the residents feel safe. And I moved to Huntington Beach, a town full of charm and a place with a sense of community. And I've been watching it slip away, and I want it back. My mom used to tell me, what you allow will continue. Don't allow it to continue. You have the power to change, but that power isn't any good unless you vote for that change.
Sunset Beach community is an important part of Huntington Beach. We must make sure to include them in discussions affecting the city. I agree with Councilwoman Hardy's position that we must increase the number of meetings of the Sunset Beach committee. I think it is important that the Sunset Beach committee be regularly involved with all our committees on council. I'd also like to expand the number of committees on council. Some of the councilmen here, or the council candidates here, have criticized high-density housing. They're right, but you know what they're not right about? Urbanization. Urbanization is fine. The problem with urbanization is when we have the high-density housing. We can have it without it, and that's what my campaign is about. My campaign is about providing services that an urban city would typically provide, as well as increasing safety, so we don't become a mass urban danger. Some ways I would like to provide services include, guess what, an event center. Similar actually to this. It would be a little bigger, but it would be in Huntington Beach. My potential site is the right next to the Art Center where the Verizon building is, and I feel it's very important that we have an event center. The event center would fill a lot of the role that the council presentations does right now, so that we don't have to have council meetings where we have an hour of presentations and then everyone needs to report public comments. But another thing I want to do, increase use of HBTV. Right now, we don't have a good TV system. We have fewer out-house reruns every day. That's not even an HB program. That's PBS. I like it. He's a great man, and I'm sorry he passed. But we gotta get some actual Huntington Beach programs. And we gotta expand them in the day. We gotta contract with Time Warner Cable and Verizon to get them on demand and much more. Policemen and firemen also need to be hired. Right now, I don't believe the city has a lot of policemen or firemen. That's a problem, especially in Huntington Beach. We need to increase the number of police, not only downtown, but in Sunset Beach. Although I will say downtown is a priority because of the amount of alcohol bars, no offense. Regarding firemen, I actually would like some sort of auxiliary, similar to what was done here for a long time ago for volunteer firemen, but more as a subordinate, not really as a volunteer firefighter, but more of an auxiliary. And that's the main thing. However, I'm now at the main issue. Homelessness. It's an issue that has affected all of Huntington Beach and, in fact, the entire United States. I will tell you that homelessness is a problem. And it saddens me to say this, but I don't believe a majority of the homeless want our help. I would like to help the homeless, but many of them are mentally ill or addicted to drugs. We need to now realize that we must focus on the homeless themselves rather than their victims. Oh, wait, the R right. Focus on the victims rather than the homeless. We must therefore take harsh punitive measures to deal with the homeless threat once and for all. Now, I will say the City Council did last meeting approve a community prosecutor to prosecute misdemeanors. That's good, but we need to do more. Another thing we need to do, we need to start working with OCTA. The mayor right now, James Taputz, he's the liaison for OCTA, and whoever replaces him, because he'll be retiring this year, needs to be someone who understands OCTA and the bus problems that cause it. I am that person. I've ran the bus since I was 16. I know that system. So I would like to be appointed to the OCTA committee if possible if I'm elected. Speaking of which, I would encourage you to vote for me on November 8th. I'm number 5 on the ballot, and I really think that's the key thing. If you have any questions for my campaign, my AAD issues I've discussed, please contact me at 714-371-5578 or email me at amory.hanson2016@gmail.com. Thank you.
Number 7, Ed Tenshaw. Thank you very
much. Hi, folks, and thank you for putting this event on. My name is Ed Tenshaw. I'm the City Council candidate. I am also your current chairman of the Huntington Beach Planning Commission. In that role, I have been very involved in the Sunset Beach community. For most of those years, I was the liaison to the city's Sunset Beach committee. I kept up on the issues here in Sunset Beach. I get the minutes regularly from these meetings from this association, and I read those every month. I know what your concerns are, and I'm very aware of those concerns, and they are my concerns. A little bit about me. I have a degree in accounting from Pepperdine University. I went to school up in Malibu. I have a law degree from the University of the Pacific in Sacramento. And I am a lawyer by trade. I have been here in Huntington Beach for about 20 years. This is my fourth year on the Planning Commission. And this will be my last year, which is one of the reasons why I'm running for City Council. I still have things to do. One of those things involves community input and transparency in government. One of the things that I've really been impressed with in my years on the Planning Commission has been the community input. And for some of you, that's very difficult. I know getting up and speaking in front of the Planning Commission or speaking in front of the City Council is not the easiest thing to do. But I'll tell you, when that happens, we make some of our best decisions. I've seen people on the dais where Planning Commissions and City Council members change their mind when they get input from the community. And input from the community is sort of like a brainstorming of ideas. We get these packets of material, which contains a lot of data. When we have issues coming up, both in Planning Commission and City Council. What we don't have a lot of is your vision of what the community should be. There are a lot of issues here at Huntington Beach, but the one issue, the core of my campaign, is the community vision. We can solve a lot of the issues here at Huntington Beach, but they need to be solved in the way that you want them solved. And that's everything from the high density. High density, I have fought most of the time that I've been here on the Planning Commission. For example, when the, was mentioned earlier, when they tried to increase the density across the street over Peter's Land, I spoke out against that. If I had been on the City Council 5 or 6 years ago, when the Beach Energy Corridor specific plan and the portable building on Main and Ellis was approved, that would not have happened. And I will continue to fight that at City Council. And I will continue to incorporate your views. This is your city, both Sunset Beach and Huntington Beach. And it should reflect your values, your vision, and the one thing that you want from any city council member is someone who's going to pay attention to that. And you know you have some city council members that do and some that don't. I promise to be one of those that will. You can email me anytime. I will respond personally. you can call me anytime. I will take a call. When I'm on city council, I will have an open door. You can come meet with me anytime. And I will make sure that what you feel this community should be is reflected in the decisions that you make. You can find out more about me on the website, edwardpinchup.com. There's some material over on the table that you need and you can take. A few issues here. Homelessness, which is getting bigger. We need to address that. I have a lot of empathy and sympathy for the homeless, but it is getting out of hand. We need to take more control of that. There are a lot of issues here in Sunset Beach, primarily which have to do with making sure that this community develops in a way that you want. When Huntington Beach annexed Sunset Beach, the city made a promise to keep the local character and flavor of this community. And there have been some attempts to get around that. And I will make sure that the city keeps that promise to you. I will make sure that the city develops in a way that you want. And I will make sure that your voice is heard on the city council. So with that, again, Edward Pinchup, edwardpinchup.com to find out more. I thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ron Sturrett, and I find myself running for city council. A little bit about myself. I'm a Huntington Beach native. I was born at Huntington Beach Hospital. My grandfather first arrived here in the late 1910s. He had to go off to serve in World War I, came back and started his family. My mother was born here in 1944. And he raised his family right here on 10th Street in downtown Huntington Beach. So we have a long family history here. I've been here for my entire life, and we have a deep vested interest in the community and what's going on within the city of Huntington Beach. Personally, I am a financial advisor. My office is on Main Street as well. I've lived downtown with my wife of 20 years, Krista. And my office is downtown. I'm a financial advisor specializing in estate planning and elder care, specifically with regards to Alzheimer's and long-term care for family members and parents. The reason I said I find myself running for Huntington Beach City Council is I, in 2014, I looked around at the city and I no longer recognized what was happening to my city. This city that I grew up surfed in, Anderson Street was one of my breaks in high school. I looked at some of the building taking place, I looked at all the cars and the traffic and the housing congestion, and I did not recognize anything. And so in the spring of 14, I determined that I was going to take some steps to actually figure out what was going on. And I interviewed me, and it was an election year. I interviewed the candidates for city council, and all of them, and I selected the ones that I thought I'd vote for, and it worked out with Eric Peterson, for myself at least, and there were some great changes that have taken place, but I feel like there's more that needs to be done. In that season, I met Dave Sullivan, and Dave Sullivan, who is appointed me to the Investment Advisory Committee. And so I've been serving on that committee for the last 2 years. I've worked very closely with many of the grassroots team here at Huntington Beach to actually stop some of the high density that was taking place. And we were actually able to change the man from 4,500 to 2,100. And that was just us picketing and attending all the city council meetings and the study sessions and asking the city council to hear our voice and to change and to do things. And we were very fortunate to get Mayor Pat Potus's vote, Joel Hardy's vote, Eric Peterson, and Dave Sullivan, and we were successful in doing so. And that's the first step. When Mayor Pat Potus and Dave Sullivan decided that they were not going to run, I couldn't believe it, and I didn't know what was going to happen. And so I found myself, I had to run. And that is why I'm here today, standing before you. I'm just a citizen as upset as anybody here about what's taking place. So that is where I find myself. That the things that I want to do are stop special interests from taking over the diets and pushing whatever it is that they want to do as far as development is concerned. And we're very, very close to actually losing that control. I want to protect your tax dollars from wasteful spending with EIRs and all kinds of different studies for various things that just is wasteful. It's unnecessary. Unfunded liabilities is a big issue for this town, and we are going to have to address that. We're going to have to look at the tier system with new hires and even transferees coming from other departments for police and fire. And we're going to have to come up with a way in order to save the pension system for Huntington Beach. Our current unfunded liabilities is $988 million. That is going to continue to grow, and we're going to have to address that. As a financial advisor, someone who understands budgets, as Mayor does, I will pour into those budgets and I will find ways to stop wasting money and to negotiate some of those contracts. My name is Ron Sterry, and I am number two on the ballot, and I respectfully ask for your vote this coming up November. Thank you.
Well, I really thank the candidates for coming tonight. I was impressed with all of them, and it's just very obvious that we have people that are running for city council for the right reasons. Their heart's in it. They have strong beliefs, and it's been a privilege to hear where they stand on issues and. We invite you certainly to stay around a little bit longer because we're going to actually finish up our agenda here in about 5 minutes, and we would like to talk to you a little bit more. Some personal business. Hey, city council is not the only election that's going on. Our city deputies, board of directors, community association board of directors has three terms that are coming up. And so I have spoken with Greg Griffin, ex-president of our SBCA, who has agreed to head the nominating committee. So Greg, I would ask that you're welcome to make your own appointments for anyone else to assist, and that we'd like to have some names at our October meeting. So for any of you who are interested in running for the board, please let Greg know. If you know someone, you know, your next door neighbor is just so cranky that the only way to get him to be quiet is have him join. Actually, we have all kinds of cranks. that's usually how we do it. So anyway, please let Greg know. The terms that are up are mine, Tim's, and Perry's. And I haven't asked Perry or Tim if they are going to rerun. That's your job.
I know.
I will put my hat in the ring right now. So thanks for getting that upgrade. Let's see, we have a LCP committee. Now, even though our local coastal plan has not been, our specific plan has not been ratified by the Coastal Commission, we have voted for one, but once we were annexed, that one went out the window, and so we are working on the new one. The new one's very, very similar to the old one, but it turns out that the Coastal Commission moves about as fast as glaciers, and we're still negotiating. But we do have the head of the LCP committee, Tim McCormick, and Tim, if you would give us an update on any of the issues that are going up. We haven't heard from you for a couple months. What's going on?
Right now, due to a house we're building on the beachfront, they wanted to change the foundations that are currently called for, the deep piling foundations. And they wanted to instead use a thick slab type foundation. So they went to the Planning Commission and made a really persuasive argument for the thick foundation, which they claim is better in a liquefaction earthquake zone as opposed to the pipings, which break and snap. So they decided, because of their presentation, that we're going to change the requirements for the oceanfront properties to allow them to have the thick type of slab foundation instead of the deep pilings that are set now. We can do that because we're going to comply with the latest FEMA regulations, which actually takes the beach out of the flood because of the depth of our beach and the way that was no longer necessary at the time. So right now we're putting together word on the beaches to send to Coastal Commission to add to our LCP. So that's where we're at right now. We're going to send the word on. So we're working on it. New things are coming up.
Thanks. Okay, we're just going to finish up here with some upcoming events and town updates. While we were gone, or while we were not having meetings, in July we had our community pancake breakfast that went real well. We made, I think, yeah, right at $1,000. We had last Saturday, we had our tribute concert. It was a German tribute band and a Led Zeppelin tribute band. And that went off really well. Barbara D'Angelo puts that on every year. And she just did a fantastic job. They haven't added up the proceeds there. But she's going to be coming to our October meeting. We'll be presenting the check, and we're looking forward to that. But where the money's going to go is we need a new roof outside the roof, and we have $5,000 allocated from last year's concert. We'll have this year's money. Las Damas is making it a priority. Las Damas is the women's organization, along with the Women's Club, that puts on the art festival and our community ball. And they're going to also do fundraisers for the roof. So it'd be great. I hope we're going to have a new roof by the art festival. As Kathy Hammond had mentioned, we're going to have the chili cook-off on September 17th, and especially for our friends from Huntington Beach that are here tonight. What we have done in the past is the winner of our chili cook-off, and there's 10 or 12 contestants, have gone on to represent Sunset Beach at the Huntington Beach Chili on the Beach on Father's Day weekend, the day before Father's Day on Main Street. And the last time we came in third. And when you figure that most of the competition down there are restaurants, and we're real proud that we've been able to compete there. A big event is coming up on October 31st. The Noble family puts on just a spectacular Halloween program. And this year, rumor has it that it's Star Wars is going to be the thing. And for those of you who have been to one of these before, you'll know that it just knocks it out of the ballpark. And for those of you who have never been to it, all I can say is you should go. You should experience this. It is it's magical. And on that note, we do have a lot of characters or a lot of people that are part of that take place in the Halloween party, and we are asking for volunteers. I'll let you explain. Are you gonna put them in costumes, or what are some things you're looking for?
Yeah. So what we're gonna do this year is a Star Wars thing, and we have probably the opportunity to have as many as 50 plus people dress up in costume and be part of all the different scenes that we're gonna do. And we have those costumes. I did do Star Wars once years ago when I lived in Fountain Valley, and when we did it that year, I think we had something in the neighborhood of about 20,000 people. And we won't have that here because I'm doing, we don't might have that same kind of issue.
What we wanted to do, though, is make it where the people in it are from our community. Last year, we did the superheroes thing. We had so many characters that were the kids from our neighborhood. They came in and did it. We managed to expand it to have volunteers to help with games and stuff. Again, for our kids here locally, we have the games. Mike was supposed to get in the dunk tank, but he didn't. So I encourage everybody to encourage him, since I'm the only one who got dunked and all that. But we are going to do a lot of really neat things with Star Wars this year, but we do need help. We need characters. Holly's always good at helping us drum up characters. But if you want to be Darth Vader, you want to be, you know, if you find something really skinny and small that I can put into a C-3PO costume, I really need that one. It's hard to find someone that tiny, you know, so that we can fit them into that name. Please come and if you want to volunteer, reach out to us. I think we've got, if everybody has Mike's number, you can just pass it on to me, or you can get mine directly. I'm really looking for a lot of people who want to actually be in the scenes and the characters. If you haven't seen the movies in a while, go watch them again, because the one thing you'll see is there is going to be at least one or two scenes from every single Star Wars movie with giant characters. We have literally life-size spaceships. We're going to have a lot of the characters and stuff directly from the movie. I have a lot of the original props. And we're going to make it fun for kids. It's going to be interactive. And we want everyone to bring your kids down, go trick-or-treating. It's all about making it fun for the community. But we really would like some volunteers to come in and be in costume, because I can build a lot of robots, but they're not nearly as much fun as having you guys directly have your families participate in it. So please try to come out and help us. We're going to make it a lot of fun for the kids, and it'll be a really neat Halloween. So please let me know if you can help.
We have something else that's coming up that's gonna be really fun this year, although it's always fun, and that is our Firehouse Ball. You know, for back in 1950, when this volunteer fire station started, the girlfriends and the wives of the firefighters started an organization called Las Damas. And in Sunset Beach, Las Damas is the workers. They are the ones that, you know, they do the work. They put on the art festival. The other big thing is they would put on, it used to be Fireman's Ball, then it's Firefighter's Ball. Once we took over this firehouse, it's called the Firehouse Ball. Anyway, that's going to take place on the Saturday before Thanksgiving, the November 19th. But it's what's going to be interesting this year, we're going to have it at the Huntington Harbor Bay Club. Not the Yacht Club, but the Bay Club, which they have, you know, has been pretty much down for so many years. But they've been remodeling it. They've given us one heck of a good deal, and I think that's going to really be a fun time. And again, the money, the proceeds from there will be coming for the new road out there. So, is there anything else that any of the board members would like to bring up or address?
Just one more quick thing. We are addressing everybody mentioned the homeless issue and things like that. One thing you might not be aware of is that Huntington Beach Police Department has done quite a bit to help with this. They've got a great homeless task force. They speak to every homeless person in town. They try to get them in help. We try to support that. There's a young lady named Kelly Rodriguez who has been here before. She's really helping to work to place these people. Having been homeless, I know what that's like, so I try to help with that as much as I can. But I think that if you look at it, she's got an email chain that goes out and says, hey, we've got this person, and here's their circumstances, and we need a little bit of help. And each one needs something different. And as they're trying to help, we can help. So I would encourage you again, look to her and look to that group to try to help, because their job is to help solve the problem and get them off the streets so that they're not in front of your homes and sleeping out in front of, you know, the bathrooms and all these types of things. They're working hard to help with that, but they do need help from us. So if you can help support that, again, you can contact the Huntington Beach Police Department. Kelly Rodriguez is really great on this. There's several other people who work on that task force.
And I think, again, they could use our help. Just as sometimes it's something very simple or very little, sometimes it's just financial, to help get these people back and on into their lives when possible. So just want to make that
announcement. Thanks. Well, we have a bit of a streak that's going on here. All year long, we have dismissed, or we finished our meetings before 9 o'clock. I've always found if you do that, you get a real good turnout the next meeting. You go after 9 o'clock, they tend to sit on and watch.
I make a motion to adjourn.
So now we've met our goal. It's before 9 o'clock, but we don't want you to rush off. We've got some very dedicated people here that are throwing their hat in the ring for city council. If you heard anything that you would like to talk to them about and get some further information, I know that they would like to talk with you. So please get up and mingle and let them know anything that's on your mind that maybe you're too bashful to speak up in front of everybody. So again, thanks so much. Thanks so much for your coming to these folks. And